नेक्स्ट है बीएस थ्योरी केमिस्ट्री सेफ्टी थ्योरी। Here job action based on theory as a model of second theories. Okay. Here first point probabilities are described as a single numeric value. This can be distortion of the precision that is actually available for supporting evidence. For example, there is a probability 0.7 that the dollar will come back to the Japanese yen over the next 6 months. When we say like this, the probability chance is 0.6 or 0.8. There is now way to differentiate between ignorance and uncertainty. These are distinct different concepts and should be treated as same concepts in our Bayesian theory. Okay. Yes, belief and disbelief are functional opposites. With respect to the classical probability theory. Yes. Okay, if p of a equals 0.3, then p of not a equals 0.7. But in our certainty factor, concept measure of belief is 0.3, then measure of disbelief is 0. This assignment is conflicting. Okay. To avoid this problem, other dimension and has student Glenn Schaefer proposed dimension Schaefer theory. Okay, dimension Schaefer. Here, considering the sets of propositions, we assign an interval Dempster-Shaffer theory, safety or DS theory, Dempster-Shaffer theory. Here, belief, we signal in interval belief. Plausible. That is, belief denotes well, which measures strength of evidence in favor of a set of propositions. Plausibility is denoted by P1, which measures the extent to which evidence in favor of not S leave room, so belief in S. That is, Pi of S equal to 1 minus P will have belief of not S. Okay. Okay. In purely Bayesian system, we can handle the both of the phenomenon by visiting all of the combinations of conditional probability. But Dempster-Shapper theory handles interactions by manipulating set of hypothesis directly. We use M the probability density function denote for all subset of theta including singleton subsets, that is individual element. Here M of P measure the amount of belief that is currently assigned to exactly the set P of hypothesis. If theta contains L elements, then there are 2n subsets of theta. We must assign M so that the sum of all the M values assigned to the subsets of theta is 1. There is first one, initially suppose we have no evidence for any one of the four hypotheses. We denote M as theta equal to 1.0. All other values of M are 0. And next second point, suppose the evidence is fever at a level of 0.6. So the correct diagnosis is in the set all flu, cold, flu, here, all flu, cold, flu equal 0.6. That is equal theta equal 0.6. Now, belief of P is the sum of the values of M for the set P and for all of its subsets. Thus, belief of P is for all beliefs that the correct answer lies somewhere in the set P. This theory can combine any two belief functions, whether they represent multiple sources of evidence for a single hypothesis or multiple sources of evidence for different hypotheses. Suppose M1, M2 are two belief functions. Okay. Here M1, M2 are two belief functions. Subsets of theta to which M1 assigns a non-zero value, why corresponding set for M2, then the combination of M3 of M1 and M1. M2 is M3 of Z equal to sigma x and z, m1 of x minus m2 of x, y 1 minus sigma x and y equal theta, m1 of x into m2 of x. Okay. We can apply this any set z1 of theta by z of theta. Here, case 1. When interaction of X and Y generate non-empty set, suppose M1 is our belief after observing flu, cold, flu, 0.6, other 0.4. Fever, 0.4, that is fever. Observing fever, this is the formula. Case 2, M2 is our belief after observing running nose. Okay. R flu cold equal 0.5, other 0.5. Okay. This is Dempster-Shapper theory. Dempster-Shapper theory, okay, sir. Dempster. Here, as we know that the probabilistic techniques are dealing with the uncertainty, they consider individual propositions and assign a numeric estimate for the degree of belief to them. One of the limitations of these approaches in their use of a single quantity to measure that may be very complex situation. Here, it opens uncertainty results from a combination of missing evidence, the limitations of truth and limitations of our own knowledge. There are some other serious drawbacks also in using Bayesian approach as a model of uncertain results. Here we have first one. As we know, the probabilities are described as single numeric values. Since probabilities are based on past results under the same circumstances, the probability assigned to current event will be the distortion of the precision that is actually available in the support of the event. For example, if we say the probability of rain is 0.8. By saying this, actually we mean we have strong conviction that there is a chance of about 0.7 to 0.9. Suppose that it will rain. Another problem with traditional probability theory is that there is no way to differentiate between uncertainty and ignorance. It means in many situations, what we term as uncertainty could be our ignorance because of lack of knowledge. These are two different concepts and hence should be treated distinctly. For example, if your car is having starting trouble and the reasons for that could be A equal to no fuel, B equal to battery problem, or C equal to writing problem. Here you have some evidence in support of problem in battery from some other source, and hence you would assign a measure of this belief P of B equal to 0.8. Here now, as per traditional probability theory, the probability of other reasons would be 0.2 and would be equally distributed between the remaining two causes. However, actually, in the absence of knowledge about causes A and C, you might not be willing to assign equal measures of belief to A and C. In fact, we might have no knowledge to justify either the amount of uncertainty or the equal division of it between causes A and B because of our ignorance about A and C. Yeah, next one, last but not the only remaining aspect of probability theory is that in it, the measure in support of some belief and a measure in support of belief, disbelief are functionality opposite. That is, if someone belief A is assigned the probability P of A equal 0.4, then we must assign the probability P of not A equal 0.6, because as per traditional probability theory, P of A plus P of not A equal 1. However, in real life situation, many times the probabilities for the belief and for disbelief could well be equal. Here, as remedy to above problem, the generalized theory has been proposed by Arthur Dempster in 1968 and was extended by his student Glenn Schaffer in 1976. It is popularly known as Dempster-Schaffer theory. Dempster-Schaffer theory. Dempster-Schaffer theory of evidence. Okay, the Dempster-Schaffer theory is an alternative approach to deal with uncertainty. It is based on the opinion that separate probability measures may be assigned to all subjects of a universe of discourse rather than just to single member, as is done in traditional probability theory. The theory considers sets of propositions assigned to each of them an interval of belief plausibility within which the degree of belief of for each proposition must lie. Dempster theory formalism. In Dempster-Schaffer theory, we assume a universe of discourse are simply a universe that you understand and a set corresponding to n propositions, out of which only one is true. We introduce here a parameter m known as a set function or basic probability assignment or probability density function. It represents the measure of belief committed exactly to any subset A and U. A belief function BEL corresponding to a specific set function M for the set A is defined as the sum of beliefs committed to every subject of A by M. Thus, belief of A is the measure of the total support or belief committed to A and reflects the minimum value for its likelihood. It is defined in terms of all beliefs assigned to A as well as to all proper subsets of A. The belief of A equal to sigma B subset A M of B. Okay, themselves rule come. Our combination. Themselves rule for combining beliefs. When evidence arrives from different sources, here we are given an exhaustive set U of mutually exclusive hypotheses. Suppose Z is defined as set of a subset of U. And our aim is to assign some measure of belief M called set function to various subsets of U. In fact, in this type of situation, all evidence is not of all elements of U directly. Rather, evidence supports different subset Z of U. Also, since we have assumed that elements of U, that is a hypothesis, are mutually exclusive, evidence in favor of some might have an effect on our belief for others. In Bayesian approach, we address the situation by considering all the possible conditional probabilities. However, in Demption-Shapert approach, we handle the situation by directly manipulating the sets of hypotheses. Let there are n sources of evidence and the amount of belief assigned to subset Z is mn of Z. Now suppose that M4 is our belief that patient goes on a trip. Now, suppose that M4, is our belief. Okay. Now we suppose that M4 is our belly. That patient goes on a trip. Okay, all 0, 5, 9. Here FC 0.48. AFC 0.32, FCP 0.12, theta 0.08. This is A value, theta AFC A 0.43 to 0.28, 0.10, 0.07. And so on. This is, we can apply the numerator of the combination rule to produce the scaling factor, scaling factor equal to 1 minus 0.432 plus 0.108, that equal to 1 minus 0.540, that equal to 0.46. Here 0.46 is associated with its outcome that are in fact impossible. If the total belief. This is the Dempster-Shapper theory. DS theory. Dempster-Shapper theory. Dempster-Shapper theory. Thank you.